Welcome to this video where we're going to show you how to build Kainan's Reapers, the Ossiarch Bone Reaper Warband from Warhammer Underworlds Diachasm. Now, before we start building, it's a great idea to get fully prepared. Here we have a pair of Citadel fine detail cutters, the tool we're going to use to remove the parts of the model we need from the plastic sprue they come on. Also, it's a great idea to have a good read of the instructions that come with the models. Doing that helps you familiarise yourself with the models and how they go together before you start building. You'll also notice from the instructions that each part of the models are numbered, and that corresponds to the numbers on the sprue, making it really easy to find the exact part you need. Now, in this video, I'm going to show you how to build Mere Kainan, the monstrous leader of the warband. But, of course, all the techniques I'm going to show you here can be applied across the rest of the warband too. Now, having a look at the instructions, it tells us that the first thing we need to do to build Mere Kainan is to make a sub-assembly of parts 13, 14, and 15. I need to find part 13 first. That's the front of Mere Kainan's body. Let's find it on the sprue. And there it is, right there, with his big face just looking out at us. Now I'm going to grab my fine detail cutters here, and as we have a look at this tool, you'll notice that on one side there's a flat edge here, and the other side a beveled edge. What we want to do is take the flat edge, put it up as close as we possibly can to the part of the model we want to keep, and very carefully snip, like so. We're going to do this around the entire model, being very careful not to cut any part off the model we don't want to. Just especially careful here around the head, like that there, spin that sprue around. Being super careful here that these cuts only go in where we want them to go. There we go, just in there like that. And working our way carefully around the model like this, just being nice and careful just to cut off the parts we want. And as we get to the last cut here, down towards the bottom of the body, we're going to hold the miniature here with our hand and just make sure it doesn't fly away as that last cut goes in. Perfect. And there we go. Part 13 is cut out. That's our first part done. With that done, let's find the next part, part number 14. That's Kainan's left arm. It's here on the sprue, this right angled piece just up here in the corner. So again, let's take our fine detail cutters here and work our way around the miniature like so, with the flat edge of the fine detail cutters up against the part of the model we want to keep. Now here you can see there's a small peg on this part. Don't cut that off, keep that peg on as it's important for building the model. And as that last part goes in, just gonna clip here like so. That's the model done. There we go. Okay, that's our first two parts of the model cut out, so let's get assembling. Let's have a look at that part 13 we cut out first. Here we go, and on the back you can see there's a number of small holes here, and they correspond to small pegs you can see on other parts of the model. Here we have that part 14 we just cut out. This is the shoulder, and it's going to go into this small hole just here. What we're going to do is just take the peg here, put it into the small hole, and just push the parts together like so, and there we go, that's our first part of the model assembled. There we go, that's our first bit of assembly done. So let's move on to the next part of the model. That's part number 15, Kainan's back. Let's find that on the sprue. And here it is, this big part right there. So what we're going to do here is once again take our fine detail cutters and work our way around the miniature like so. Just being super careful not to cut off any vital parts or bits of detail like this. So just making sure we're not cutting off those bits of bone on the shoulder there. Perfect. And as this last cut goes in, again, we're holding onto the model to make sure we don't make it fly away. And there we go, that's part 15 cut out. Okay, with that part cut out, let's assemble the whole body. Let's take parts 13 and 14, which we assembled earlier on. Here they are, just here, and you can see on the back there's two more holes, one here and one there. They're going to correspond with the two pegs on the back of part number 15. You can see one at the top there and one at the side. They're going to go into those two holes. Now, a top tip here is to take the shoulder tab that's on the top left here of Kainan's body and just push it into the underarm first. Then, find those two holes together and push the whole part of the model together, like so. Okay, with his body done, it's time to find the next part. That's part number 16, Kainan's giant Soul Reaper axe. Let's find that on the sprue. And here it is, right there. Nice and easy to find. So again, let's take our fine detail cutters and just very carefully work our way around the part of the model like this. Again, making sure that the flat part is up against the parts of the model we want to keep here. Working our way around very carefully like so, holding onto the model and taking our time just to make sure we're not snipping off parts of the model we want to keep. There we go, perfect. And then along in there, here on the haft of the axe, just be super careful again. It's quite delicate here. There we go. And then as the last cut goes in here on the axe blade, just going to take hold of the model here. And there we go. That's part number 16 ready to go. Okay, with the axe cut out, let's put it onto the rest of the miniature. First of all, let's have a look at the Kainan model we already have assembled. Here we have the model right here, and you can see there's a large hole in the centre of his chest. Well, that corresponds with the peg on the back of part number 16. What we're going to do here is place the two parts together like so, making sure the peg goes inside the hole, and then clip the model together like this until you hear a bit of a click. Also, make sure on the wrist here, his arm is attached to the hand as well, so just push those two parts together. That's Kainan almost built, but of course he needs a base. It's part number 17, let's find that on the sprue. Here it is on the sprue, it's the largest base in the kit. It's got his 2 feet attached as well. So let's grab our fine detail cutters and work our way around the side of the base like so, making sure the flat part of those fine detail cutters is flush up against the side of the base like so. We'll work our way around like this, and then with the last cut going in, we'll take our base ready to go. Now you'll see on the base, it's got two holes there, and they correspond with the two pegs on Kainan's feet. So we're going to place those two pegs inside the holes, give it a push, and there we go. We have a finished Mere Kainan miniature. And with that, Mere Kainan is built and ready to lead his warband into action. Don't forget, you can use these same techniques to build the other members of the warband too. Now, there's a couple of things to remember when building this warband. First of all, you might be super tempted to cut all the parts off the sprue and have them lying in front of you to build them. Don't do that. All the parts on the sprue are numbered, and leaving them on the sprue will make it much easier to find the right bits you need. Second of all, when you're cutting parts off the sprue with the fine detail cutters, use the flat side of the fine detail cutters to make sure you get a nice, clean cut. Hope you've enjoyed this video. Happy building!